Hello everyone, welcome to Nija Education. Today we are going to discuss on class 9 chapter, that is, what is democracy, why democracy. Before understanding this term democracy, we must know the forms of a government. There are different types of a government. First is monarchy. Monarchy is a kind of a government where a monarch is a hereditary ruler. Means monarchy mein jo king hote hain wo hi rule karte hain. और ये हेरिडेटरी है. हेरिडेटरी मीन्स अगर किंग का डेथ होता है तो उसके बाद उसका जो सन होता है वो ही रूल करता है. सो इट इज कॉल्ड अ हेरिडेटरी रूलर. सेकंड इज डिक्टेटरशिप. डिक्टेटरशिप इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ अ गवर्नमेंट वेयर अ पर्सन और अ पॉलिटिकल पार्टी हैज अ पावर टू डू वॉट एवर दे वॉन्ट. मतलब यहाँ डिक्टेटरशिप में कोई एक ही पर्सन होता है या एक ही पॉलिटिकल पार्टी होती है, उसके पास पावर्स होते हैं कि उनको जो पसंद है वो कर सकते हैं. हियर यू कैन टेक द एग्जांपल ऑफ अ हिटलर. मिलिट्री रूल. मिलिट्री रूल मींस हियर द मिलिट्री ऑफिसर्स ऑफ द कंट्री कैन रूल द सिटीजन. सो इन दिस थ्री फॉर्म ऑफ अ गवर्नमेंट देयर इज अ नो रोल ऑफ अ पीपल. हियर पीपल इन दिस थ्री फॉर्म पीपल कांट चूज देयर रूलर. फोर्थ इज डेमोक्रेसी. डेमोक्रेसी इज a form of a government in which the rulers are elected by the people. You have seen this first three form. Here people can't choose their ruler, but in a democracy people have a right to choose their ruler. So you can see the definition. Democracy is a form of a government in which the rulers are elected by the people. Now by seeing this definition, severe questions arise in our mind. That is, who is the ruler in this definition? And if rulers are elected, what kind of election constitute a democratic election? Or here it is written, the rulers are chosen by the people or elected by the people. Now, who are the people who can elect the ruler or elected as a ruler? So, here every citizen has a right to choose their ruler on an equal basis. And fourth, here you can see form of a government. Now, what kind of form of a government is democracy? In democracy, rulers can do whatever they want. मतलब के अगर ये democracy is a form of a government, अगर rulers को choose करके लाया गया है by the people, so this elected rulers can do whatever they want in a democracy. So these are the questions by saying this definition. These are the questions which arise in our mind. So let us consider this all question with the help of some example. Major decision by elected leaders. Now in this we will see the case of Pakistan. We will find out is Pakistan is a democratic or a non-democratic country. Let's see. Pakistan. In Pakistan, General Pervez Musharraf led a military coup in October 1999. That means जनरल परवेज मुशर्रफ ने मिलिट्री को अपने कंट्रोल में ले लिया था इन 1999. जनरल परवेज मुशर्रफ हिमसेल्फ इज अ मिलिट्री जनरल. नाउ आफ्टर दैट, आफ्टर टेकिंग कंट्रोल ओवर द मिलिट्री, ही ओवरथ्रू द डेमोक्रेटिकली इलेक्टेड गवर्नमेंट इन द पाकिस्तान. मीन्स उनके आने से पहले वहां पे ऑलरेडी डेमोक्रेटिकली इलेक्टेड गवर्नमेंट थी, बट ही ओवरथ्रू दैट and he declared himself as a chief executive. Later on, he declared himself as a chief executive of the Pakistan, that means the leader of the country. Later on, he changed his designation to the president. He changed his designation to president and became the president of the Pakistan. In 2002, he held a referendum that granted him 5-year extension. Now, what do you mean by the referendum? Referendum means a vote in which all the people of the country or an area asked to give their opinion about or decide an important political and social question. उन्होंने ऐसा कहा कि people चाहते हैं कि वो और भी 5 साल तक वहाँ पे rule करें. But this referendum was protested by human rights organizations, democracy activists and Pakistani media. They said that this referendum was based on malpractices and fraud. In August 2002, he issued a legal framework order and amended the constitutions of Pakistan. Amended the constitution of Pakistan means he made changes in the constitution of a Pakistan. Now, according to this constitution, president can dismiss national and the provisional assemblies. जो वहाँ पे already democratically elected होके जो national और provisional level पे जो assembly थी, उन्होंने वो dismiss कर दी. After that, now according to this law, the work of civilian cabinet is supervised by National Security Council. जो भी civilian cabinet थे, उनका जो work था, that is supervised by National Security Council. Who all are the members in the National Security Council? They are military officers only. So, if military officers are the member of National Security Council, that means they are also in the control of General Pervez Musharraf. तो उनको भी जनरल परवेज मुशरफ ही कंट्रोल कर रहे थे, तो उसके वजह से ये जो सिविलियन कैबिनेट का वर्क है वो भी डायरेक्टली और इनडायरेक्टली कंट्रोल बाय द जनरल परवेज मुशरफ. सो आफ्टर दिस इलेक्शंस वर हेल्ड इन पाकिस्तान टू इलेक्ट द मेंबर्स ऑफ अ नेशनल एंड प्रोविजनल असेंबली. नाउ द पाकिस्तान हैज हैड देयर इलेक्शन, दे इलेक्ट देयर रिप्रेजेंटेटिव एंड हैव सम पावर्स, बट the final powers are the rest in the hands of a general Pervez Musharraf and military officer. So here the elected representative are like a puppets of a general Pervez Musharraf. So is Pakistan is a democratic or non-democratic? By seeing this example you will understand that Pakistan is a not a democratic country, because here all major decision and the final decisions are taken by the general Pervez Musharraf and he is not elected by the people. And even the military officer also not elected by the people. Here election, they are holding an election regularly, but the representative are under the control of General Pervez Musharraf only. So you have seen in the Pakistan that the rulers are not elected by the people, and even if the elections are going on, then also that representative is not able to take a decision, and he don't have any right to take a decision. Final decisions are taken by General Pervez Musharraf and by the military officer. So you can definitely say that Pakistan is not a democracy country. So by seeing the case of a Pakistan, we will get our first feature of a democracy, that is, in a democracy the final decision making power must rest with those elected by the people. Means agar democracy mein election ho rahe, if you are electing your representative, then he must have a power to take all the decisions.